It is a privilege to represent the United States Postal Service as we honor the life and achievements of Dr. Chien-Shiung Wu, one of the most influential nuclear physicists of the 20th century. And we believe that today, the International Day of Women and Girls in Science, is perfect timing for this dedication. Dr. Wu made enormous contributions to our understanding of radioactivity and the structure of the universe. During a career that spanned more than 40 years in a field dominated by men, Dr. Wu helped discover a fundamental law of physics, the non-conservation of parity. Her pioneering work on the Manhattan Project during World War II helped harness the power of the atom. She was also a lifelong advocate for women in education and science. Her honors and awards include the National Medal of Science, the Comstock Prize, the prestigious Wolf Prize in Physics, and induction into the National Women's Hall of Fame. She was also the first female recipient of an honorary Doctor of Science degree from Princeton University, and the first woman to serve as president of the American Physical Society. For her many extraordinary accomplishments, Dr. Wu is known as the First Lady of Physics.
She was born in 1912 in a river town north of Shanghai. At the time, girls weren't really educated. Her parents founded a school that educated her. And at age 11, she exceeded their ability, and then she had to go to boarding school. And then she went away to university, and then she went away to the United States. She left China when she was 24 years old. And then war broke out between the Chinese and the Japanese. And then World War II happened, and Mao happened, and she never got to see any of her family members alive.
In the Chinese community, she was a superstar. If you went to a Chinese restaurant with her, it was like Elvis walked in.
I didn't know my grandma was famous when we were growing up. She was just my grandma. Over the years, we would go to her apartment in New York, and I saw it was covered with walls of photos. And it wasn't until I was, 12 or 13, that I started asking who was in the photos. And it was Pope John Paul and Muhammad Ali and Zhou Enlai, leader of China.
She was a hero to my parents. My parents came to the U.S. as students. And when they came over, their intention was just to spend a couple of years studying and go back to China. And what happened, they ultimately lived the rest of their lives in the U.S. because of the profound changes that happened, political changes that happened in China.
When I worked with her, she worked very hard. We have to run experiment on a wonder graph accelerator, the day and the night for over a year. And she would come in every morning at 7 and stay until something like 1 or 2 in the morning. You see, remarkable. She worked very hard. She wanted to make sure everything done right. She wanted to check everything through. You know, that's very unusual for a professor.
In high school as a senior, I was taking physics. And I remember extremely vividly in January 1957, our teacher got very excited about a report in the New York Times that day of a very exceptional meeting at the American Physical Society, which held an annual meeting in New York. And this was a meeting in which people were basically hanging from the chandeliers. And it was the meeting at which Professor Wu's experiment for non-conservation of parity experiment was announced.
When you look at the world, It has certain behaviors. And if you looked at the world in a mirror, you'd expect it to have pretty much the same behaviors. Whether you're looking at the real world or the real world in a mirror, it should all be the same. And that's what is known as parody symmetry, that, you know, a mirror interchanges left and right, and you would expect that that difference should not have any profound impact on the inner workings of reality. And what Madame Wu did, she undertook an experiment. She took an atom of cobalt 60, which it decays into an atom of nickel, and it emits certain particles that have a handedness. They spin either in one direction or another, a right direction or a left direction. And she showed that the mirror image of the decay process that was happening in the laboratory, the mirror image could never happen in the real world. Only one of those two things could happen. And that established that this left-right symmetry that we thought was just a convention. The universe doesn't care about left or right. She showed that the universe does care about left and right.
She would always mention that the number of women in senior faculty member positions was very limited. And she thought that was not fair. Not just that they might not get their accomplishments recognized, but she thought it was terrible that women couldn't have necessarily the same ambitions and hopes that men could if these opportunities were limited.
Even to the present day, women are extremely underrepresented in physics, in general, in sciences, but in particular in physics. And in some ways, she was ahead of her times, because back in the 1970s, when I was with her, she was very supportive of women physicists.
This stamp is being issued as a forever stamp in panes of 20. It will always be equal in value to the current first-class mail 1 ounce price. Now, at this time, we're pleased to officially unveil the Dr. Chien-Shiung Wu forever stamp.
It is so gratifying, and it is so important, so inspirational, that this stamp bearing the image of a woman who pushed the boundary of understanding in a profound way, and for it to be released on a day that itself is dedicated to celebrating and inspiring women in science, this is a wonderful event.
I can imagine her smiling. I mean, she had a characteristic smile when she was thinking about some things that pleased her and tickled her.
I think that she would love being on a stamp because she loved writing letters and she loved sending letters, and that was a lot of how we communicated. So I think that the fact that it's a forever stamp and you can use it anytime, you know, maybe I'll start writing more letters.